It's been, honestly, it's been more than a little bit. Hope you guys are having a good summer,
good morning.
It's pretty early, but we have a little bit of catching up to do, as I have been very busy. I've been really busy, yet super active offline, I guess you could say. I've been MIA for the most part. So I just want to, like, touch base, do some live studies, because I do make a lot of art. I do practice a lot. I just don't stream a lot of it, and I should. So we're gonna touch base as to what I've done in the last, like, month I haven't streamed, and show you what I've learned, and then show you some practices I've been doing, and then we're gonna do some live practices, demonstrations. So we're gonna start off with this piece, being the most recent one I've made. There was a reference used for this, but it's a bit of a twist. Let me see if I can pull up the reference here. It was a black and white reference, and this one was more of a study on color rather than my rendering skills, I guess you could say. So I'll take a look at it. Let's find the folder for it. Here we have, you know, the reference, and then if I just jump back to the photo, you see it's not necessarily one for one, more or less just trying to capture the feeling. But we're gonna walk through how I did this, and then what the reason I'm so like proud of this piece, and that's mostly because I figured out how to finally do gradient maps, and gradient maps save lives. If I turn this off, it'll jump back to the black and white variant. That's just a gradient for the background, I know that. So, doing this wasn't all too difficult. It was mostly just a three-step process. As you would usually, I started with a regular sketch, a base sketch. Turn off the shadow too. It's a strong starting point. We added in the flats, of course, you know. And then we plotted in a bunch of the shadows, most of the shadows, and I like to render my shadows as I go. So plotted in the shadows and rendered as we went. Plotted in the lights. And then this is just an extra layer of rendering. So this is where like everything happened, so I really like to work in just very few layers. So 90% of the rendering happened here. It kind of just takes a huge jump. But this is pretty much like the finish point for this study. I didn't want to spend too much time on it. But I added in the small features like the hair, the eyes. Didn't draw in the nose and the mouth because they weren't really necessary, but maybe I was just being lazy. Was added to the fold here. Yeah, nothing too revolutionary. The undershadow, or the shadow connected to the leg, and then the actual shadow, which I added in after everything, just right there. And then I added the background, of course, because, you know, the olive green background. Not even olive green. I don't know what type of green this is, but my green background isn't all too appealing to the eye. Add that in there and make it a gradient, nice, simple, lazy backgrounds. And this is where we get to like the fun. Grouped everything and applied a gradient mapping for the skin. And all I did for the gradient mapping was I transitioned into warmer highlights and then cooler shadows. So if you look right around the thigh area, see it's kind of at its darkest point. You can see that these shadows right here are very, very cool. In here as well, and like even in the belly button area. Very cool shadows, just to contrast the super, super bright and warm light that we have. I think the only exception where it doesn't fall are just like, not halftones, but just slightly lighter shadows, I guess you could say. So these areas where it's transitioning into the shadow, that transition point, that's where it's like slowly going into, like here. You can see that this little sharp jut out, and that kind of blended this out more, but I kind of like the whole impressionistic look of it, rather than something more renaissance-ish. But that's that, the most recent one, how I to one that I started on stream but did not finish on stream, and I definitely should have finished on stream because it's probably one of my best pieces. But we're gonna go to this girl. So she took around 3 days, and I do believe you guys have already seen the photo reference for this, but if not, I'll just pull it up here real quick. So this was the reference for this piece. I really only like use the reference as like guideline for shadows and highlights, and work from there. So running through the steps, it's the same as my usual ones, except this one involves a little more rendering, a lot more rendering considering she took 3 days. But I combined some basic cell shading with the flats. This was all done on stream, so everyone has seen this, but from there, this seems like a really big jump, but it's really not. I'll take away a lot of what happens here. Basically, on one layer, I just plotted in a lot of the shadows. It's less so plotting, it's just like graphing them in. And we're gonna ignore this lights layer for now, because it's gonna come in until a little later, but we added in the lights. And then from there on, we just. We went in here, and I immediately, this is the shadow, so we're gonna ignore this. We added in the patterns, and this is just basic matte painting, so the patterns are not painted all by hand. That would be ridiculous. I'm not sure. I'm fairly confident it's called matte painting. Basically, I took a photo image and I like applied it to a selection of the kimono, and then I painted over that in order to get it to work. So you can see the lights here that we plotted out from earlier. They're showing through because the pattern is on it's on a pass through mode, a divide layer. That's what I have mine set to. And then this one is on screen because I like the way both of them look. Tattoos, done the same way as usual. I just photo placed in the tattoos, so, and then painted over them, so just matte painted again and warped them to make them match the skin. Definitely it could have been done better, especially here. I wanted sort of dots of skin peeling through the tattoo breaking, but they were definitely way too large. I should have can't do anything about that. I just have to move on now. Painting's done. I don't want to look back. I want to keep moving forward. We have this basic pass-through mode, and our final layer is more of like a light layer. So we have our shadows in here and all that. But yeah, the final layer that we work with was essentially just painting over the matte image. And as you can see, we kind of adjusted the brightness and contrast of the final image versus the practice image. But that is that piece. And we are going to be doing something completely not related to this. We're going to be practicing today, not with gesture drawings like what I've been doing, but with, I guess, simplification. We're going to be looking at some references and then just sketching them out and then trying to show value with only two, with like a bare minimum of two colors, I guess you could say, per area. So I have an example, or some examples I've done, kind of just been in black and white to build up to the color stage. So we have all these. Just a basic painting, trying to show someone in black and white using just geometric shapes. And we will be working from references as usual. Because reference helps me build up that visual library. So, without further ado, let's start this one. I'll show you the reference we will be working with today. And then we shall get on with this. I'm feeling so weird. I've been warmed up and not yet. So, I think for our first reference, we're gonna do this for our first reference. Yeah. So we're just gonna get a little quick sketch and then put in the skin and then put in a hard shadow color. Let us begin. kind of see the body, the shadows, you know, just pick a darker color. And it's starting to move. That looks. Thank you.
Thank you. Going. I think the more important part about this is, yes, it's helping you see shapes, but also it's just forcing you to make decisions as much as you want. Thank you. chair and all.
Going to conclude the stream for today.
Before I end, this is watching after. I do plan on having a bit of a look back stream, happening on the 24th, so in about 16 days, in around 16 days, July 24th. I'm gonna look back at when I started this whole digital art journey. July 2020, and to compare it to where I am now. So we're gonna see 2 years progress. It's gonna be kind of, it's like a motivation thing for anyone who's looking to get into art, to show that if you just kind of focus, you can get places. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and see you guys next time, which will be very soon. Definitely before the 24th, because there is something I want to start doing. Yeah. Goodbye.